Chronic sinusitis affects over 1 million people a year. You and I may get 1 or 2 sinus infections a year, those symptoms of which are facial pain and pressure, yellowy-green discharge out of your nose, headache, fatigue, but those usually resolve in just a couple of days. People with chronic sinusitis have symptoms that persist in between those infections, and they get many more infections per year than the normal or average person. And so they're constantly dealing with feelings of fatigue, of headache, and of facial pain and pressure. Typically, a bout of sinusitis, a patient will go and see a general practitioner, a pediatrician, possibly an allergist. But when that sinusitis is not treated and isn't going away and is persisting for more than 3 months, then that patient will most often be referred to an otolaryngologist or an ENT surgeon, and that is an ear, nose, and throat specialist. So an ENT has a variety of options for treating chronic sinusitis. They always start out with medical management, and there are a series of medical prescription options for treating sinusitis. However, about 20% of people with chronic sinusitis don't see those symptoms resolve with the use of medication. And those are the patients who are candidates for surgery. Sinus surgery is often called functional endoscopic sinus surgery, or FES. And patients will go to a hospital, to an operating room, for that surgeon to remove some of the bone and tissue within their nose and their sinus anatomy in order to open the passages from their sinuses into the nose so that their sinuses drain more fully and that those rounds of infection are resolved. Following surgery, most patients will see resolution of their symptoms. Some patients do have to come back for revision surgery, and some patients do have to continue to manage their disease with medical options, and surgery provides partial relief but not full relief to their disease. I would say one of the surprises that came up in cycle of care analysis for chronic sinusitis has been an increasing trend to the office, to doing procedures on awake patients under local anesthesia. ENTs are pretty well versed in doing procedures in the office setting, in the clinic setting, but over the last 20 years, there had been a trend towards complicated surgeries in the operating room because you could manage both bleeding and patient pain more appropriately in that setting. With the advent of new technologies and with a focus on minimally invasive tools, you're seeing more and more procedures migrate back to the office. So something that can be done with local anesthesia and allowing patients to return home and be back to work within 24 hours.